Hey everybody, this morning. Everybody still asleep, huh? Well, let's stand up right now and let's give the Lord a hand clap. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen. All honor and glory to our King. Amen. Praise God. We appreciate the internet being with us this morning. We pray that God's going to bless you right where you're at, even all over the world. And we thank you so much for hitting our website. I think Jeanette was telling me it's about 72,000 folks hit us, and we're proud of that, we're not just in this house. We're all over the world. Amen. We give God the praise and glory. Amen. Praise God. Let's give him another praise. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. He's a good God. Amen. Good to see everybody this morning. We're going to go to the Lord in prayer. Got a couple things I want you to remember. I want you to remember the food pantry back there. We want to get that thing built up because there's big some plans for that thing to really help start helping the community. So if you can remember to bring some groceries and stuff, canned goods and stuff like that, and tunas and juices and beans and cereal and rice and things of that nature. But if you can remember to do that, we want to, believe B.R. and Thelma, want to build it up. And at the end of the month, they're going to start trying to give out some to the community. So that's a big project that's going on. And we can be a part of it. It can be part of our alms to help some of the folks out there that needs help and groceries and things of this matter. Amen. So we want to look at that today.
Brother Ricky, yes, ma'am. A couple of verses of scripture, yes, that I got this morning concerning the food pantry, and you know, I just got to give it. So,
amen. Do it.
It won't take but a second. It's just two verses. It's Ecclesiastes chapter 11, verses 1 and 2. It says, "Cast thy bread upon the water, for thou shalt find it after many days. Give a portion to seven and also to eight, for thou knowest not what evil shall be upon the earth." In other words, your blessings, when you cast your bread upon the water, your blessings will be returned. Amen. To the one who's generous. And also, if you just don't know, there may be a time when you might be in need. And that's what that verse is saying. So cast your bread upon the waters. And so if you can just bring a can, just bring one can, that would be good. Because if everybody brings a can, we'll about have that tub back there filled up. Okay, God bless you.
Amen. Praise God. You know, praise God for that word. God's pleased with that. Amen. You know, and if you can bring 10 cans, bring 10.
Or aluminum.
Yeah, amen. Praise God. Good to see you by this morning. We're going to go to the Lord in prayer. And our sister Erlene, come on in here. God bless you, sister. We love you. We're going to go to the Lord in prayer. We've got some folks that need praying for this morning. We're going to look at also, but let's go to the Lord in prayer this morning. Father, we love you and we praise you this morning. We worship you, God. We honor you, God, in Jesus' name. God, we pray, God, that you'll just be with Sister Cox this morning. We lift her up to you, God, and Donna and that family, God, in Jesus' name. We pray you'll be with me, Ma, and heal her body, God. And Lord, we pray you touch my mother and just touch her ribs, God, and heal them, God. Lord, be with us today, God. We want to glorify and magnify you. I pray, God, you'll anoint the praise and worship to glorify you. I pray you'll anoint the ministering of the word, God, and fall on good ground and spring up and bring much fruit, God. We ask it, God, in Jesus' name, Lord. And Lord, we love you this morning. We pray you'll touch the congregation, Lord, and meet spiritual needs and physical needs and financial needs, whatever the need might be this morning in this house, God. We pray your anointing power will fall in here and meet some of those needs, God, in Jesus' name, Lord. Those needs. And those folks on the internet, God, I pray right where they at, God, that they've tuned in to us this morning, God, that you're going to bless them right where they at, spiritually, physically, or financially, what the need might be, God. I pray, God, Holy Ghost, that you'll just rest upon them. Holy Ghost, have your way in this service this morning. Move in like a mighty rushing wind and just have your way, Father. In Jesus' name, we ask it, God. Amen and amen. God bless you. Yeah. Amen. Praise God. We don't do that this morning. We got some folks that need some prayer this morning, and we want to pray for them. Are they here? I don't believe they're here, are they?
One is here and the other's not.
Okay. One is here and the other's not, but
if anybody else wants to be anointed with oil and prayed for,
we're gonna anoint.
God wants to touch you this morning.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes, we got some. We want to pray for some folks this morning that need special prayer, and one is not here this morning. Little Sammy, we want to pray for him that God's going to move on him because he's got a serious thing going on Tuesday. I believe an operation or something on a kidney or something. But we want to pray.
Worship.
Huh?
Go ahead and do worship.
Okay. Those that need prayer, Sister Jeanette is going to be praying. I'll help. If you guys want to go ahead and start doing praise and worship, and you ladies, let's just praise God. Amen. Anybody need special prayer, come on down with this call right now.
Yeah. flows from Emmanuel's veins, and I will rejoice. I will rejoice and be glad. I will rejoice. I will rejoice and be glad. There is a fountain full of grace, and it flows from Emmanuel's veins. There is a fountain full of grace, and it flows from Emmanuel's veins. And I sins all away. came and he healed me. He came and refreshed me. He came and washed my sins all away. He came and he healed me. He came and refreshed me. He came and washed my sins all away. Still flowing, amen.
Hallelujah.
This river's still flowing, praise
Hallelujah.
God. This river ain't stopped. Hallelujah. It will flow as long as we don't dam it up. Amen. If we'll just let it flow, praise God. The river's still flowing today. The river of life is still flowing today. Hallelujah. You might need healing this morning. You might need some peace to flow in your life, praise God. That's the kind of river we're talking about. A river that will purge whatever is blocking it up. Amen. Hallelujah. If we'll put something into it, we'll get something out of it. Amen.
Yes.
Is that too mean?
Glory to God.
That's just the truth, ain't it?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If we'll put some praise in it, we'll get something out of it. Amen.
Yes, we will.
I don't know about you. I need my blood flowing a little bit this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm a little sluggish getting going this morning. I need something to kind of pep me up a little bit.
I see a moya, amohoya, asiki, ahashai, kaya wohoya. I am more, iamo osaki, kiki, ahasi. Ishamahaya, iamo hokoya, amohoya, mahasi. Isi awahashai, kaya hashaya. Ishi amohokoya, mahasi. Ishi amohokoya, aya, haya. I am a horsey. Hallelujah. There is a river of the sweet Holy Ghost, and it is flowing among God's people today. If they would just reach out and take it, it's there. It's prepared for them to receive from God. There's so much in your life that you need to turn over to God. There's so much that you carry. There's so many burdens in your life that you're carrying around, and God is saying, give it to me. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of our God. There is a river of the sweet Holy Ghost. And see how it bubbles and see how it flows. Let it bubble and flow in your life today. God has a plan and a purpose for you. And not only the adults in here, for every child, God has a plan for you. And God is saying to you this morning to reach out and receive what he has for you today. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Let's stand together and let's worship our God. When we come to church, we come to worship. We come to cast our cares on him, but we come to worship him, to let him know how much we love him, and to thank him for all he's done for us during the week. We have a grateful heart before him. Let's express it to him this morning. Amen.
Come on and bless that wonderful name of my Jesus. Bless that wonderful name. of my Jesus. Come on and bless that wonderful name of my Jesus. There's no other name that I know. Come on and help us bless that wonderful name of my Jesus. Come on, bless that wonderful name of my Jesus. Come on and bless that wonderful name of my Jesus. There's no other name that I know. Well, now there's power in that name of my Jesus. There's power in the name of my Jesus. There's power in the name of my Jesus. There's no other name that I know. Come on and help us bless that wonderful name. Jesus, come on, bless that wonderful name of my Jesus. Come on and bless that wonderful name of my Jesus. There's no other name that I know. Well, now there's power in the name of my Jesus. There's power in power in the name of my Jesus. There's no other name that I know.
Okay. You know, God loves us so much. And you know, I just feel like we need to have a little Jericho march in here this morning. And if the girls would get the flags and let's go around and let's shake hands with people, but let's march as we shake hands. Come on, let's march in this place this morning. We want to get some life in here because Jesus is alive forevermore. He's alive in your heart. He's alive in your life. And Jesus is alive.
Bless that wonderful name of my Jesus. There's no other name that I know. Well, now salvation's in the name of my Jesus. Salvation's in the name of my Jesus. Salvation's in the name of my Jesus. There's no other name that I know. That wonderful name of my Jesus. Come on and bless that wonderful name of my Jesus. Come on and bless that wonderful name of my Jesus. There's no other name that I know. Yeah, there's healing in the name of my Jesus. There's healing in the name of Jesus. There's healing in the name of my Jesus. There's no other name that I know. Come on and bless that wonderful name. That wonderful name of my Jesus. There's no other name that I know. Come on and bless that wonderful name of my Jesus. Come on and bless that wonderful name of my Jesus. Come on and bless that wonderful name of my Jesus. There's no other name that I know. I love my Jesus. I love my Jesus. Love him in the sun go down. I love my Jesus. I love my Jesus. Love him in the morning. Love him in the noon. I love my Jesus. Love my Jesus. Love him when that sun goes down. Come on and help us bless that wonderful name of my Jesus. Come on and bless that wonderful name of my Jesus. Come on and bless that wonderful name of my Jesus.
I love my Jesus. I love
In the name of my Jesus. Well, now there's power in the name of my Jesus. Yes, there's power in the name of my Jesus. There's no other name that I know. Come on and help us bless that wonderful name of my Jesus. Come on. Of my Jesus, come on and bless that wonderful name of my Jesus. There's no other name that I know, that I know, know that I know. There's no other name that I know, that I know, know that I know. There's no other name that I know.
Now that's what I call having church. No namby-pamby church. We're not that. We are Holy Ghost filled. We are spiritual, and we let the Holy Ghost lead in this church.
Amen.
And to me, there's no other way. It's got to be Him, and it's got to be us lining up with what He wants to do in the services. Glory to God. Praise God. Aren't you proud of the kids? Let's give them a hand. They can worship and they can keep on going when I get out of breath. Amen.
Tithes. Tithes and offering.
I believe somebody's got a word, and I don't know who it is. I just feel like somebody's got a word this morning for the church. I know Ricky has because he's got a message that's burning in his heart. But does anybody have a word? And if you do, go ahead and give it now because it needs to be done right now.
I'll say something real quick. Right before you started that Jericho March, I said something to Richard. You was talking about the river. And I said, well, if you're in your boat and you just sit there, you're experiencing where you're at in the river. But until you actually do something and move, you don't experience the rest of what God has for you in that river. You can stay where you're at and enjoy it, but God's got so much more.
Amen, brother. Yes.
And then you did the Jericho March, and I said, well, that pretty much said it right there. But that's what we need to do. We need to move and not stay where you're at.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We need to get a little closer every day, don't we?
Hallelujah.
Instead of farther away, we need to get closer and closer and closer to the Lord. I'd like to ask their ushers if they would come now and receive God's tithes and our offerings. Did you mention this prayer request today about Debbie across the street, Ricky?
Do what now?
There's a Debbie across the street that's working over there. And she is asking prayer for her son. It's giving her a lot of trouble. And Mary Cox is sent home now, and she's with hospice there. So let's remember the family. They thought that she would pass last week, but God has His plan.
Amen.
Not man's plan. Not what doctors think. Sometimes they're wrong. Amen. We believe God's report. Ronnie, would you pray, please?
Most kind and gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day, Lord God. And Lord God, today we ask you, Lord, this Debbie across the street, her grandson, Lord God, she's having problems with him, Lord. And Lord, you are the problem solver. And Lord, we just ask you for that. And Lord, we just ask you to bless these tithes and offering. Use them up with your kingdom in Jesus' name. Amen.
Sabra's going to sing, ain't she? Yeah. God, hallelujah. Amen. Sister Sarah, come on up here. Our special this morning. Praise the Lord. Ah, we got some help. Come on. We need some more microphones, don't we? Come on up here. Praise the Lord. Just an honor for these folks to be up here. We love them. Let's give God all the honor and glory for everything's accomplished here this day. Amen. Just give him a hand clap. Amen. Praise God. Let me see if I can get some more microphones.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise. Amen, because he's worthy of all of the praise. Amen.
Check.
And my daughters and I are going to sing praise the Lord, everybody, because I know when we go through things and trials in our life, we know we got to give God all the praise, because when praises goes up, blessings do come down, and we just want to praise him and glorify his name.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord. Everybody ought to praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Everybody,
praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Everybody, praise the Lord.
There's a storm cloud on the ocean, and it's moving this way. If your soul not anchored in Jesus, it will surely drift away. There's a storm cloud on the ocean, and it's moving this way. If your soul's not anchored in Jesus, it will surely drift away.
Well, clap your hands, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Clap your hands, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Clap your hands, everybody.
Praise the Lord. Everybody ought to praise the Lord.
I'm a soldier in the army of the Lord. I'm a soldier in the army. I'm a natural born soldier in the army of the Lord. I'm a soldier in the army. I want to live so God can use me anywhere at any time. I want to live so God can use me anywhere at any time. He's all right.
He's all right.
He's
says he's all right.
He's all right.
He's all right.
He's all right.
My God is all right.
He's all right.
He's all right in the morning.
He's all right.
All right in the new day.
He's all right.
Yes, he's all right.
He's all right.
He's all right.
He's all right.
He's all right. He's all right.
All right. 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 All right.
Well, praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord. Everybody ought to praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise God. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Everybody. Amen. You know, that's just an honor that what Sister Sarah done up there with daughters. I just look for the day, God, that me and my sons and daughter would get up and do something like that. Hallelujah. To have your children praising the Lord. That's just a great thing. Amen. Let me get these things also. We'll have no backlash here. Praise God. Hallelujah. Just an honor to praise him and to worship him. Magnify him. We're going to press on. Amen. No matter what the enemy throws at us, we're going to press on. And that was very good, Sarah. I like that. Didn't even have music. We're going to get some music in there and try to help next time, maybe. We need to practice, though, don't we? Geraldine plays the guitar. We got to get her picking on that thing. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Huh? Yes. Practice tonight at 5 o'clock, right? 5 o'clock practice tonight for the choir, so y'all be here. And y'all be praying for us, too, because some of us be going to the prisons in Columbia tonight. Y'all be praying that God will be just move in that situation and touch those folks down there. I've been praying God's going to move in a special way. Amen. If you got your Bible and you want to follow along with me this morning, I'm excited about this. It's amazing things going on in your life during the week. Hey, you need something. My message this morning is on God of all comfort. Anybody ever needed to be comforted in here? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Praise God. Because a lot's going on in our lives. Amen. Things go on in our lives continually. And these times, praise God, that I just need to call on my Lord, my comforter. And praise God, he is always there. He'll never forsake us or leave us. He is always there in times of tribulation or trouble in our lives. We can call on God, and he is our comforter. Amen. So we're going to look at some of God's word this morning to see what he has for us. I'm excited about this message this morning, all of God's messages. Amen. The one tonight that God has, I'm excited about it because this is his word. His word is truth. If you got your Bible, you want to follow with me, I'm going to be in 2 Corinthians 1:1-7. I'm going to read a little bit here. Well, I'm going to start with verse 2. In 2 Corinthians 1:2. Grace be unto you, peace from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. Praise God. Look here. Blessed be God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all comfort. I like that right there, don't you? I tell you right now, when you get in God's word and you start reading God's word, you can get comfort in God's word. How many times you've been going through your life and things is going on and you realize it and there's turmoil going on in your family or things going on and all of a sudden you're needing something. Say, hey, I got to stop. Something's going on. I got to get this stopped. And you get God's word, his Bible, and you start reading in God's word and you get that comforting peace that comes upon you because you start reading God's word. Amen? It's exciting, isn't it? I tell you right now, and it is to bring an immediate peace to you when you start getting God's word and just looking at it. You can get comfort from God's word. You need to get in God's word and study God's word and read God's word and just fill up with his word. And the more his word you get in him, I'm telling you, the more peace and comfort you're going to get from him. Amen. Because you're going to be assured that God's going to be with you whatever comes your way during that week or during that day or whatever's going on in your life. You can be assured and be comforted in knowing that God is going to be with you regardless of what's going on in your life. Amen. And he's concerned about you, you know. You know, we was in Sunday school this morning teaching about the word and some stuff, you know. You know, God already knows your needs and what's going on in your life, but he wants you to pray. See, when you pray, that's an act of faith that you love him and you trust him. So he wants you to pray to him. He already knows what's going on, but he wants you to pray and cry out to him. And that's showing faith and trust in him. Amen. He's the one that we always need to rely on. Look at here. Blessed be the God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all comfort. He's the God of all comfort. Praise God. What does that say again? Who comfort us in all our tribulation. What were we talking about a while ago? Anybody ever have tribulation in here? I tell you right now, I got my share, amen. But I tell you right now, I'm going to stand my ground because God is going to see me through it. And God is going to comfort me through it. I tell you right now, I've been into some terrible tribulation times in my life. And I just use that as an example. And I can remember crying out to Almighty God, Charles. And guess what? He comforted me during those troubled times of my life. He was always there, praise God. And it's so much reassuring to know that he's there. I remember one time Jenny told me a testimony about her when she was a young woman. I'm going to tell about this, Jenny, a little bit. But she was going through something in her life, and she was about to die. She had gotten sick, and she was about to die. And, you know, she told me, she said, Brother Rick, but I knew, you know, I was about to die, and this was going on in my, what was happening, but I was comforted because I knew I had a peace about what was going on because I knew God was with me regardless of what was going on in my life. And it was a peace about that time. Amen. And we were kind of sharing a little bit there. I was in that bad car accident about 5 years ago. And I'll never forget, it was such a terrible time. I woke up about 2 or 3 days later, and they thought I was going to die, and I did die a couple of times. They brought me back. They brought me back to life. But I'm going to tell you right now, when I woke up, you know, my arms was all swole like Popeye, and, man, I had every kind of tube in me you can think of, and I was like, where am I at? What's going on? And when I come to my senses, I realize. But I still, during this tragic time of my life and my body in the shape it was, I still had a comfort that my God was with me, and I knew that. And you know, the first thing I wanted to happen when I got my consciousness after about 2 or 3 days, I come around, my son and my wife and my daughter and them, some of them were there in the trauma center, and they were there looking at me on that table and everything. The first thing come to my mind when I got my senses, where am I at? What's going on? What's happening? I knew I hadn't read my Bible in 2 or 3 days because they told me I'd been out for 2 or 3 days, unconscious or something. And the first thing I wanted, I asked my son, Jason, my oldest son, read the Bible to me, boy. He went and got the Bible. He come stood by my bed, or the thing they had me on, and he read the Bible to me. And guess what it did to me immediately? It gave me peace. It gave me comfort that I was in his hands. I was in his hands. Regardless what's going on, I was in his hands, and I was comforted about that. And I was saying, God, you can, you know, if I'm going to be with you, I'm ready. I'm comforted. Or if you're going to heal me, I'm comforted. You know what God told me his word? He said he's going to heal me. He told me beyond a shadow of a doubt, praise God. Jeremiah 17:31, I believe it is. He's going to heal my body. And he healed it, praise God. And so I was comforted during that troubled time in my life. That's just one time. I imagine as many of you out here this morning can think of times that you was in terrible tribulation or something's going on in your life that you needed a comfort and assurance about it. And you can call on God. If he's your Savior, you can call on him because he'll be there. He will never forsake you. He will never leave you during these times. Amen. He will comfort you. Rest assured, praise God. Look at here. Let's read some more of his word right here. The God of all comforts. In verse 4, who comfort us in all our tribulation, that we may be able to comfort them which are in any trouble by the comfort wherewith we ourselves are comforted of God. You know, I got, boy, just keeps on talking about comfort, don't it? That's what the Lord brought to me about this message. You see the scriptures I have here. It's about comfort. I want you to tell my people that I'm the God of comfort. Amen. He's a God who can comfort us. And you know what it is right here? As I testified about how God comforted me in one of my tribulational time, and Sister Jenny went through some terrible times during that time, and God comforted her. Now that we've been through some of these things, guess what? When we see our brothers or sisters that might be going through some things like that, we can comfort you because we've been in some of those positions, and we can tell you what God did for us, and He'll certainly do it for you. Amen? Because He loves you that much, praise God. And He wants to comfort His children. Amen. We need to be comforted and rest assured that He is always with us, no matter what we're going on in our lives. Amen. I can remember many times calling on Him in a foxhole and the enemy trying to kill me. And I cried out to God, and I wasn't even a Christian. I had been a Christian, but I wandered away from God. But I can remember being in a foxhole, crying out to God, God, please get me out of this. Please get me out of this. And even at that time, crying out to God in a foxhole, He was with me then. He comforted me then because I was crying out to Him with an honest heart. He loves us. He loves His creation. Amen. Let's go a little bit further right here and look. And it says right here, for as the suffering of Christ abound in us, so our consolation also aboundeth by Christ. Whether we be afflicted, it is for your consolation and salvation, which is effectual in the enduring of the same suffering which we also suffer, or whether we be comforted, there's that word again, comforted, it is for your consolation and salvation. And our hope is steadfast, knowing that as ye are partakers of the suffering, so shall you be also of the consolation. Now, I'll tell you right now, God is our Savior. He is our King. Amen. He is our Comforter, too. You know, it's an amazing thing when you get on salvation. Salvation has got so much in it. Amen. Salvation plan, you go in and study the word salvation, you've got so many things there. And part of that is He is our Comforter. He is our Savior. He's our Provider. He is our great I Am. That's who He is. He's the Rose of Sharon. All of that comes when we receive the Lord Jesus Christ in our heart and become a believer and get in His kingdom, praise God. We have these things. We can rest assured that He'll always be with us and comfort us during the things that we're going through. Amen? He's a mighty God. Let's look at Isaiah 61:2. I want to read that. Love Isaiah. This is what God gave me when He, some of the stuff God gave me when He ordained me the priest, beyond a shadow of a doubt. I know He did. He talked to me through this. To proclaim, I'm supposed to, when He anointed me to and called me to preach the gospel, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all that moan. So we as Christians might have someone in our families or around us or something that's going through some hard times or something, you know. And we need to cry out for them to the Lord. And we need to try to comfort them and assure them if they'll put their trust in Almighty God, they can be comforted with Him and be assured because their trust will be in Him. Amen. He's a mighty God, isn't He? He is so wonderful. Look at here. Let's look in John 14:18. I want to read. This is talking about the comfort of the scriptures. Now, you know, in John 14:18, it talks about the scriptures. Now, what can the scriptures do? I talked about it earlier. When you're going through things and things happening in your life, if you'll get in God's scriptures that He has given us, that's kind of like a down payment of what's to come. Amen. Praise God. He has given us the Word of God, Him speaking to us. And you can get in that Word of God and you can start reading in areas and cry out to God to reveal things to you. And what does the scriptures do to you when you get to reading them and studying them and looking at them? They give you comfort, don't they? They give you reassurance, amen. See, we're getting reassurance this morning listening to God's Word and talking about God's Word that we apply it to our lives and we go forward in that in our walk with Him, amen, because He's a powerful God and He loves us so much. It's a, it, you know, it's an honor to be able to get in God's Word. To get in God's Word and His Scripture is a comforting thing, isn't it? I don't know about y'all, but I have to have it every morning. It's like before I go out of my house, I got to read God's Word. If I go out at 4 o'clock in the morning, I got to read His Word before I go. If I go out at 6, I got to read His Word. You know, I got to have that comforting assurance in the morning as He speaks through me through that Word as I go out in my daily walk with Him. Amen? So we see in God's Word right here, I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. Now, see, He's with us, and in the Scriptures, He's with us. Amen? So you can talk to God and get with God and have that assurance of Him in the Scriptures. Amen? Let's look a little bit further right here. That was in 14:18. It's talking about, I will come to you. If you pray to God, I got my notes. If you will pray to God and cry out to Him and see His precious Word, praise God, it says right here, I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. Is that what God says? He will come to you. And He will be with you. And He will fellowship with you. It's a comforting thing knowing that He's with you. Amen? Let me give you an example here before I move on to the next one. You know, this week I had some things going on, and me and Becky's had all kinds of things going. She's been in the hospital 7 days, all night and all day, 24-hour day with her mother. Mother's really bad off, you know, and we've been doing some of that. And I had a couple of things I had to do, one financial thing I had to do, and I asked God, what do I need to do? What's the best way to do this? And, you know, I just cried out to God. This is a decision I need. I want help at, you know. You know, God also wants you to cry out to Him on small things in your life too, not just big things. But I was able to cry out to God about this situation. And I said, God, what do you want me to do? I want you to tell me what's the right thing to do here. I want to do what's right, and I want to do this. Or I don't want to do this. Tell me what to do. Well, I prayed to God about 2 or 3 days there, and then all of a sudden, Brother Steve, he started talking to me and told me what to do. So I did it. And you know, when I did it, I come out of there and I felt so good. I was comforted because I knew that God told me what to do and I did the right thing. Amen? So it really felt good that I can cry out to my God. He is a true living God. And you can talk to Him and He'll talk to you if you'll seek Him. Amen? So I was able to do that and make a decision that I know was right because He spoke to me and told me what to do, the right thing. Amen? That's comforting in our walk with the Lord, isn't it? To know that we can do that. Now, that's talking about, he said, I will come to you. Let's look on down here at Romans 14:4, and it's talking about the comfort of the Scripture. I had these two wrote together. They joined together here a while ago. In Romans 15:4, I believe it is. 15:4, I believe, Ronnie. I might have wrote it down wrong, but it's 15:4. There we go. Look here. For whatsoever things were written aforetime were written for our learning, that we may through patience and what? Comfort of the Scripture might have hope. Amen. Now, I don't know about y'all, but I got hope this morning. Well, I know you do too if you're a Christian. I'm going to tell you right now, if the world's fixing to be destroyed, if the economy's fixing to collapse, our government's fixing to fall, I don't care what's fixing to happen. If you're a Christian and you've got the Lord Jesus Christ in your heart, you're going to be comforted and you're going to have hope. Why? Because God says so right here. The Scriptures will give us that hope and the Scriptures will give us that comfort. And we just read where Jesus Christ would come to us and give us that comfort. Comfort in what? He's in control. Comfort in what? He's coming back. Comfort in what? He has everything in control because He's still in control and He always will be. Amen? He's a mighty God, isn't He? That's comfort. Look here. Comfort of the Scriptures that we might have hope. Now, how do you do that? You get in God's Word and you see those comforting things that He tells us. His Word is truth and He has given us His truth and we can read it and look at it. And by doing that, the Scriptures gives us comfort, doesn't it? Amen. I don't know about y'all, but I need it a lot. Praise God that we can do that. We can get into Scriptures and get that. Amen. I like that one right there. Let's go a little bit further right here and look in comfort of the Holy Ghost. Now, God said He would give us the Holy Ghost, didn't He? And that's a comforting thing. Let's look in Acts 9:31. See, I want to tell you what God's Word says, and I want you to establish yourself and be grounded in God's Word, that no matter what you're going through, and these things you go through sometimes, say, well, they don't know what I'm going through. They ain't walking in my shoes. Well, God does. He knows all about it. He knows everything about you. He knows your heart. And He loves you. He loves you. Now let's go a little bit further right here. Look right here in Acts 9:31. Then had the churches read throughout all Judea and Galilee and Samaria, and were edified and walking in the fear of the Lord. That's reverence to God. Edified, lifted up because of God. Hallelujah. In the comfort of the Holy Ghost were multiplied. Now we in the comfort of the Holy Ghost this morning. You see, we come in here and guess what? We've been praying. Some of us been praying that the Holy Ghost would have His way in this service this morning. We submitted to Him to have His way in here. Praise God. And praise God, He has had His way in here. And by that, we're comforted because of that. Amen. And God has given us the Holy Ghost, praise God, for our comfort. And He'll never forsake us and He'll never leave us. Let's go a little bit further. Comfort of the Holy Ghost. Let's look and see. Let's look at 2 Corinthians 1:3. Blessed be to God. We just read that a while ago. I got it right here. Blessed be God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all comfort. He's powerful. He is our source. Amen. We got to depend on Him because He is the King of kings and He is the Lord of lords. And He's the one we cry out to. He's the one we depend on. Praise God. I'm going to a place in my Bible. I want to just look real quick and see if there was something there that I was supposed to bring out also. You know, the source of our comfort, who? It's God, isn't it? The source of our comfort is also the Holy Spirit. We just read that in the book of Acts 9:31. The Scriptures is a source of our comfort, praise God. And what is a source of our comfort this morning? Preaching of the Word, amen? You know, I hear the Word or hear the Word on TV or somebody preach, Sister Jeanette preach something, boy, that's comforting to me, praise God. That goes with me out this door and the rest of the week, that preaching of that Word is found good ground. And I pray that it'll spring up and bring much fruit in our lives, amen? So that's some of the sources we can look at. What's some of the other sources? The love in Philippians 2:1. We can look at the love that the children of God have. We're supposed to be Christ-like. And one of the main things we're supposed to be like is what? Example of who? Jesus Christ. Amen. Jesus is our source. I tell you right now, when you get in that cardinal world out there and the spirit man starts fighting against that cardinal world and that spirit man, sometimes, you know, you got to settle it with the spirit man. Hey, I'm going to be like Jesus. I'm going to be an example like Him. And that cardinal man that wants to do these things is not going to, in Jesus' name. Amen. So there's a warfare going on there. Amen. And we fight against that. But I tell you right now, you cry out to God and guess what? He's going to be with you and He's going to help you and He's going to comfort you during times that's going on in your life. And we just seen that right there. If you want, it says blessed in verse 3 of 2 Corinthians. Blessed be God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all comfort. That's powerful. He's the God of all comfort. All of our comfort comes from our Almighty God. You know, Almighty God, you can see Him. You can go out there and look at the sun, the stars, the moon. You can look at them beautiful trees that's turning, those maple trees that's turning. It look like they're on fire. You can see God's glory in them. And we give honor and glory to our God because why? He created them. He made them. He made each one of us too, praise God, because He loves us. He loves His creation. He also wants us to be comforted. You know, I'm going to tell you right now, I need to be comforted a lot down here, though, because of the curses upon the earth, things that's going on down here. But when I get to be with my God, I'll be with the Comforter forever and ever. And that's comforting just to know that, amen, that we're going to be with Him for eternity, not just a little while. So our rewards, things that we're doing down here for our Lord Jesus Christ, and it's coming from our heart because we're doing them, we're going to get rewarded in heaven. And we don't do it because of them rewards. We do it because we love the Lord thy God. Amen. That's why we do it, because we love Him. We're here this morning. Why? Because we love our Father and He loves us. Amen. Praise God. Let's go a little bit further right here. I'm going to read that to 2 Corinthians, the fourth verse too, again. Who comfort us in all our tribulation, that we may be able to comfort them which are in trouble, and comfort wherewith ourselves are comforted of God. I tell you right now, tribulations and things we're going to go through. Jesus said we're going to have tribulation, but don't worry about that, because he's going to be with us regardless. Amen. He'll never forsake us. He'll never leave us. That's comforting to me to know that. Amen. In Hebrews 13:5, he said he'll never leave us, never forsake us. I believe what his word says. Amen. Praise God. Let's look here. Let's look a little bit further. We see the comfort of God. And Psalms 23, that's a great Psalms. Psalms 23:4. I want to read just a little bit right there. It says, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff comfort me. And thou preparest a table for my enemies. You know, God is so powerful. He's such a powerful God. He is with us. He comforts us through the things that we have to go through. And we have to go through them because it rains on the righteous and the unrighteous. And guess what? The enemy of this world hates us. That's no problem, because our God has conquered death, hell, and the grave. Amen. It's a done deal. And we're on the right side. Praise God. I don't know. I don't even know who won the ball game yesterday. Supposed to have been a great ball game, but I know who wins this one. Our Lord Jesus Christ. You read in the back of the book, the Christian wins, because we serve our risen Savior. He is alive. We're talking about a risen Savior who is alive. He's not dead. We can cry out to him. He talks to us. He answers us. He provides for us. He does all of those things that he promised in his word. His word is truth. Praise God. Hallelujah. Let's look in John 14:16. Forever is talking about forever. John 14:16, the word of God says. I love the chapter 14, John the Gospel. Look here. And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you what? Another comforter, that he may abide with you for a little while. Now that word says forever, doesn't it? Read it with me. And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever. The Holy Ghost is going to abide with us forever. He's always going to be with us. He'll never leave us, praise God. So that's comforted in this morning, knowing that God is always with us. He'll never leave us, praise God. He'll never forsake us. I don't care where we're at or what we're going through. We can always cry out to God. And he's there. And we can comfort one another with these words. And I want to talk to you about this last scripture here I want to look at. No, I got two more. 1 Thessalonians 4:18 talks about comfort one another with these words. 1 Thessalonians 4:18. This is a comforting thing to a Christian. And other religions and people of the world, they don't believe like this, but praise God, we know it's the gospel, the good news. It's God's word. Look at here. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. Now, what is that talking about? Jesus Christ is coming back just like he said he would. He said those dead in the grave will be called up in the air, C-A-U-G-H-T. And it says those who are alive will be called up in the air with them. That's talking about the rapture. See, we can comfort one another with these words this morning, knowing that we have the Lord Jesus Christ in our heart, praise God. We can comfort each other with hope and these words that we're going to be with him for eternity, forever and ever. And let's just look we can comfort each other with that. Now let's look at Revelation 22:20. He's going to come quickly. And if you don't have him in your heart, I'm talking a little bit to the folks on the internet here. If you don't have the Lord Jesus Christ in your heart, when he comes, you will be left behind. That's going to be a tragic thing. I tell you right now, it's an awful great feeling this morning to be comforted with the hope and the words that our Lord Jesus is coming back, and he's going to rapture us out of here. And if we don't go by the grave, we're going to be raptured up alive. Amen. I truly believe we're the generation that's going to see the coming of the Lord. And I'm going to tell you here right now, this morning, we can comfort one another with these words. Hey, our Lord's coming back. What is your hope this morning? Our Lord Jesus is coming back just like he said he would do. The prophets prophesied, the Hebrews, Yeshua was coming back for thousands of years. Well, guess what? He came back like he said he would do, praise God. And he did. The purpose on this earth was to defeat the devil. He accomplished that, praise God. And he sits at the right hand of the Father. And he is interceding for you and I this morning, praise God. So what is your hope this morning? What is your comfort this morning? And our Lord Jesus Christ is coming back again. Amen. You can be comforted with those words this morning. Amen. It's exciting to know that, praise God. I'm talking to some of the folks on the internet this morning too. This Jesus Christ we're talking about has been prophesied for 2,000 years by the prophets in the Hebrew. He came 2,000 years ago. He died on a cross. He was buried. And on the third day, he rose up. He's the first of the begotten alive. Praise God. And he was seen by over 500 of the brethren. The gospel shares and shows that to us in the word. And God's word is true. You can have this Lord Jesus Christ if you want him. If you would just cry out with an honest heart and say, God, come into my heart and forgive me for rebelling against you and sinning against you. See, that's where your problem is. When you come against the true living God, the great I am. But if you'll ask God to forgive you, he is a God of mercy and grace, and he loves you. He will forgive you. He will forgive you. Ask him to forgive you because he loves you so much. Ask him and he'll forgive you if you mean in your heart. And if you'll confess him with your mouth, the Lord Jesus Christ, the Bible says, thou shalt be saved. If you'll confess him and believe it in your heart, not your mind, get you a Bible, start crying out to him. He'll reveal himself to you like never before. I pray that you do that this morning. I pray that you just ask and seek the Lord Jesus Christ. See, the only way to get to heaven, the only way to get to the God we serve is through his son Jesus. That's the only way. And if you want the God we serve, acknowledge his son Jesus, what he did for you and I. And the Bible says, thou shalt be saved. Amen. It can happen. I pray you did that this morning. I'm going to pray. I just ask everybody to bow your head this morning. Praise God. He's a mighty God. Anybody in here today that would like to see receive Jesus as your Savior and you're not saved, raise your hand. Anybody here in a backslidden condition, raise your hand. Praise God. Anybody in here need that message of comfort this morning, raise your hand. Oh, uh-huh, yes. I see them hands. Praise God. This preacher's, both of his is up. I give God all the praise and glory for his scriptures, for the sweet Holy Ghost, and for our Lord Jesus Christ, God the Father, God the Son, the Holy Ghost. We thank you. We love you this morning. We pray you'll go with each and every one here this morning. You'll bless them in a special way. And God, you're the God of comfort. You'll be with each one of us this day and this week in the name of Jesus. And everybody said amen and amen. God bless.